Welcome to a video on the product and quotient of complex numbers in trig form. Let's take a look at what happens when we multiply two complex numbers together in trig form. Well, first we can see that R1 times R2, of course, would be R1, R2. Next, if we multiply cosine theta 1 times cosine theta 2, we would have this product. Cosine theta 1 times I sine theta 2, if we rearrange the order of the terms, we'd have I cosine theta sine theta 2. Next, we'd have I sine theta 1 times cosine theta 2, as we see here. And then our last product would be I sine theta 1 times I sine theta 2. So we'd have I squared sine theta 1 sine theta 2. Next, this term stays the same. I squared is equal to negative 1, so this term is the same as minus sine theta 1 sine theta 2. These two terms have a common factor of I. So if we factor out I from these two terms, we would have I times the sum here. Now what we'll notice is that this difference can be used with the cosine sum identity to get cosine of theta 1 plus theta 2. And this sum, using the sum identity for sine, can be simplified to sine theta 1 plus theta 2. So if we want to multiply two numbers together in trigonometric form, we just multiply R1 times R2 and multiply that by the cosine of the sum of the angles plus I times the sine of the sum of the angles. Let's go ahead and do an example. So here's the formula. Multiplying these together is quite straightforward. Multiply 2 times 3, that will give us 6. And then we just find the cosine of the sum of the two angles, pi over 3 plus 11 pi over 6. Well, pi over 3 is the same as 2 pi over 6. So 2 pi over 6 plus 11 pi over 6 would be 13 pi over 6. And of course, it's going to be the same I sine theta of 13 pi over 6. Next, we just need to evaluate the cosine and sine of this angle. Remember that 2 pi is one complete revolution around the circle. You can think of 13 pi over 6 as 12 pi over 6 plus pi over 6. This is equal to 2 pi, so that's one complete revolution, and then an additional pi over 6 radians. So there's 12 pi over 6 plus pi over 6. This would be a 30 degree reference angle. So we have 1, 2, square root 3, and now we can evaluate this. So we'd have 6 times the cosine of 13 pi over 6 would be square root 3 over 2, plus I times the sine of 13 pi over 6 is 1/2. So we end up with 6 times square root 3 over 2, and 6 times 1/2 I. Well, that would give us 3 square root 3, plus 3i. Let's go ahead and take a look at the quotient of two complex numbers in trig form. We won't take the time to go over all the steps here, but if we have a quotient of two complex numbers, the key to coming up with this formula is to take the numerator and denominator and multiply it by the conjugate of the denominator. So we multiply both the numerator and denominator by cosine theta 2 minus I sine theta 2. When we do that, notice the denominator becomes cosine squared theta 2 plus sine squared theta 2. Remember, that's equal to 1, so that eliminates the fraction. And then in the numerator, what we can do is use the difference identities for sine and cosine to come up with our final formula. So for finding the quotient of two complex numbers in trig form, we just divide the r's and then find the cosine of the difference of the angles and the sine of the difference of the angles. Let's give it a try. Again, here's our formula. So this will be equal to 24 divided by 6, that would be 4, times cosine of the difference of the angles. Notice it's a numerator minus a denominator, so 150 degrees minus 30 degrees will be 120 degrees, plus I sine of 120 degrees. So it's pretty straightforward. Let's go ahead and plot this angle in standard position. This would be 90 plus 3 degrees. So that means we have a 60 degree reference angle. So we have 1, 2, square root 3, where this 1 would be negative. So we'll have 4. The cosine of 120 is negative 1/2. And the sine of 120 degrees would be square root 3 over 2. So we'd have negative 2 plus 2i square root 3. You can see that using this formula to divide complex numbers in trig form is actually easier than dividing them in rectangular form. I hope you found this video helpful.